वेरी गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर सेशन। वेलकम टू अक्षर एंगल क्लासेस। दिस इज द फर्स्ट योर फिजिक्स फैकल्टी। इज माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? या शैल वी स्टार्ट द सेशन? या सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव बीन गॉन थ्रू द फ्रिक्शन चैप्टर, एम आई राइट? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट न्यू चैप्टर, लाइट। अंडरस्टैंड? Light chapter. So better write on the chapter name light. New chapter it is. New chapter. Understand? Now light. So before starting about the light, you should learn something about light chapter. Light. The concept of light, what is meant by light, what it will do, what are the characteristics, everything will end here. Understand? So let's start the day. Light, better write down, light is a form of energy. Light is a form of energy. Understand? Light is a form of energy. What is meant by energy here? Energy means It is a capacity to do work. What is mean by energy? It is a physical quantity having capacity to do work, which means that light is also having a capacity to do work. Understand? Next, light will help you to us. Tell me. Light is a form of energy, one thing. Yes. And what light will do to us? What it will help to us? It will make the object visible. Understand?
Yes.
It will make the object visible. Light is a form of energy. It will make object visible, and the speed of light is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Understand? What is the speed of light here? 3 × 10⁸ means that in 1 second the light will travel a 3 lakhs distance. Understand? In 1 second, that is the speed. That much is the speed of the light. You know, from the sun to earth, how much time it will take to receive the light? From the sun to earth to travel light.
8.6 seconds.
Yeah, 8.8 minimum, approximately 8 minutes time it will take. Not seconds. 8 minutes time it will take to come light from the sun to earth. Understand?
Yes, sir.
At the same time, light is a electromagnetic wave. Light is a electromagnetic wave, that is called EM wave. Understand? EM wave means,
yes.
Light consists electric fields and magnetic fields while traveling in the vacuum. Okay, when light is traveling, it consists what and what? Electromagnetic and electrical field and magnetic field. It consists when it is traveling in the vacuum. That is the reason we call it as a electromagnetic wave. At the same time. Light is a electromagnetic wave and it has a dual nature. Light has a dual nature. What is mean by dual nature? Dual nature means sometime it act like a particle nature, sometime it act like a wave nature. So write down, dual nature means particle nature. Particle nature, and second one is what? wave nature, particle nature and wave nature. Light having particle nature and wave nature. Understand? So these are the some important points related to what? Light. So what is the mean by light? It is a form of energy. And what it will do? Make the object visible. The speed of the light
is
3 × 10⁸ meter per second. It is a electromagnetic wave. And what is the nature? It has dual nature. Dual nature, what is the dual nature? Particle nature and wave nature. Got my point?
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. So next, it has properties. Light having properties. Will you write properties of light? Yeah, better write on properties of light. Properties of light. The very first property is rectilinear propagation. What is the first property? Rectilinear propagation. And the second property is reflection of light. Reflection of light. Understand? Second point is what? Reflection of light. Third one is refraction of light. Are you writing?
Yes.
Refraction of light. Fourth one is dispersion. Dispersion of light. And the fifth one is interference. Interference. Sixth one is, tell me, sixth one. Dispersion of light, interference. Sixth one is diffraction. And seventh one is polarization. These are the properties of light. Understand?
Yes,
so you know one thing here. One sec. Yeah, yeah, right. You know one thing here. One secret is behind here. One secret. We have a one secret here. Can I say the secret? Can I say the secret? The secret is this.
Your voice is coming low.
It is okay now?
Yes, no.
It is okay?
Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Actually, here the secret we have. What is the secret? These four properties will explain by particle nature. With what nature will explain these four properties? Particle nature. And these properties are explained with the wave nature. Understand? These four properties explained with particle nature. These three properties explained with what? Wave nature. Got my point? Actually, write down definition of optics. Understand? Optics. What is the optics? What is mean by optics? Optic means it is a study about light. It is a study about light and its properties. And its properties. Study about light and its properties. Called optics. Understand what is mean by optics?
Yes,
the study about light and its properties.
Light and its
properties called optics,
properties,
which means
optics.
Study about these seven. The study about these seven properties, nothing but what? Optics. Here, optics is a branch of physics actually. Again, it has two branches. Understand? Again, it has two branches. The first branch is ray optics. Ray optics. And the second branch is wave optics. Understand? The first branch is what? This one and this one both are mingled. We will call as optics. But here it is divided as two sub branches, ray optics and wave optics. Actually, ray optics is explained in this four properties of light, and wave optics explain these how many properties of light? How many properties of light? These three properties of light. Understand? Ray optics explain this four, and the wave optics explain this. Which means, in the wave optics, we'll discuss these three properties. In the wave ray optics, we'll discuss these four properties. In the wave optics, we'll discuss these three properties. Got understand? Got clarity? Yeah. Next, let's learn about one by one about these properties. Studying about the properties is nothing but study about the what? Study about what? Study about light. And understand? Let's start one by one the study about this thing. Can I start? Completed? Yeah, so very good. Now write down rectilinear propagation of light. Rectilinear propagation of light. Rectilinear propagation of light. So this is the first, what? This is the first property of light. What is this rectilinear propagation of light? What is this rectilinear propagation of light? Light, is it appearing? Light always, light always travel in a straight path. Light always travel in which path? In a straight path. This is meant by rectilinear propagation of light. Understand? Light always travel in what way? Light always travel in what way? light always travels straight way, which means, for example, here we have a wall. Here we have a wall. When this is a wall, this is the way we have a wall. Now light is coming this way. When light is coming this way, is the light travel skip this wall and go this way? Tell me, light will skip this wall and jump this wall and go the straight again? No, it can't happen like that, correct? So which means that indirectly it is telling that light is always travels in a which direction?
Straight.
So that is a property, is a first property of the light. So because of this property, what are the events happen in this daily life? What are the events happening in our daily life? What is happening in the Yeah, look at here. Because of this rectilinear propagation, we are having shadows. Understand? If the light not having the property of straight line motion, we cannot observe the shadows if not having. Understood? Because of the straight line motion of the light, due to that we are having the shadows. If it is not having, shadows cannot form. Not only shadows, you know, the solar eclipse, lunar eclipse also happened due to this rectilinear propagation of the light. If this rectilinear propagation of not having by the light, we cannot form the solar eclipse, lunar eclipse. Am I right? But how do you prove this? As an activity in the classroom. How do you prove it as an activity in the classroom? We can prove in two ways the light is having a straight line motion. One is by using the cardboard experiment. One more is by using the pinhole camera. Understand? Let's first do the activity, verify the activity, cardboard activity. Let's take a cardboard here. First of all, take a candle. This is a candle. The candle is burning. The candle is burning. Now here I'm taking how many? I'm taking here cardboards. This is the way I'm taking the cardboards. First cardboard, and this is a second cardboard. Okay, now this is a third cardboard. How the arrangement of the cardboard here in a straight line? All the cardboards are in the same horizontal level. Now I place a hole at middle exactly, and observing this candle from the outside. I'm observing the candle through this holes outside. So when you observe this from the outside, what going to be happen? Surely the light will pass through this holes, so that you can observe the light, candle light. Am I right? But if you change any one of the cardboard, change the position of the any one of the cardboard, will you observe this candle through these holes?
No, sir.
No, why? Why you cannot?
Light can't pass upside down.
Yeah, upside down. Light always travels in a straight line motion.
Path.
So that you only observe when the cardboards are having in a straight line position, so that you can observe the light outside. Understand?
Yes, sir.
So this is what happened. This way we can prove that light having the straight line motion. Understand? This is a small experiment. One more experiment also there, that is called pinhole camera. let's do the pinhole camera experiment. Shall I do?
Yes, sir.
Now, again, pinhole camera. You know, in the pinhole camera, how the image appears? Upright or upside down?
Upside down.
Upside down. Why it will appears upside down? Let us see now. Okay, now.
Okay.
For that, I'll take a candle once again. This is a candle.
Yes, sir.
Burning. This candle is burning now. Candle
okay.
is burning. Now, here I am having the screen. Opposite side we have a candle. Understand? Exactly opposite we have a candle. Now, due to this candle, burning candle, is this screen will illuminate or not? Appears bright or not? It will bright, because this from the candle light rays will fall on the not wall, this is a screen. From the candle light rays will fall on the screen, so that the screen appears very bright. Got my point? Now what I did here, I kept a opaque object in front of the screen. Between the screen and the candle I placed a opaque object. When you place opaque object, is the screen appears bright now?
No, sir.
Why?
Because the light can't reach the second screen.
Light cannot move through the opaque object. Am I right? Now, for this opaque object, I will make a small hole.
Okay.
Very, very small hole. This is a very, very small hole. So, this is the way I made. When I made, this is the way. Now, what going to be happened? I'll take two light rays from the top of the candle. This is the top of the candle. This is the way if I take light rays top of the candle, this is the way light rays are passing. Is this light ray make the bright the screen? Is this light ray? Tell me. Is this light ray make the screen bright? I'm asking question. This light ray is passing this way. This light ray make the screen bright?
No.
Why it is not passing through the opaque object? So this light ray cannot make the screen bright. Now one more light ray observe from the same point. Is this light ray make the screen is bright? No.
No, sir.
Now this light ray. This light ray?
No.
Now what about this light ray? Why? Because through the Now this light ray is coming from where? From the top of the candle. Am I right? So this is the top of the candle. From the top of the candle the light rays are coming. And it is illuminated at here. Got my point? Similar way, let me take some other light rays from the bottom of the candle. So this is the bottom of the candle. Now this way light rays are passing. Is this light ray make the screen bright?
No, sir.
Then this one?
No, sir.
And this one?
No, sir.
And this one? Yes. So this way light rays are illuminated. So this light ray will illuminate it here. But this is coming from where? This point, kada?
Bottom of the candle.
Means bottom of the candle appears at where here? Top side of the screen.
Yes, sir.
Top of the light is appears at where? Bottom of the screen.
Bottom of the screen.
So that it will appear. How it is appears? How it appears?
Reverse.
That is called inverted. Why? The inverted image is appearing here. Why it is inverted is appear here? Because straight line path. Understand? if the light is not going in a straight line path, this topmost position can't reach here, gada.
Yes,
same way this bottommost can't reach top of the screen, gada.
Yes.
So if it is not having, so but it is not happen like that, surely it will giving a inverted image, since we can say light is passing in a straight line motion or not. So we can, this is a pinhole camera actually. This is the mechanism happen in the pinhole camera. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So note down this to remember long time. Note down this. After this, we have a terminology related to light. Let's learn terminology related to light. Shall I talk about terminology related to light?
1 minute, sir.
Yeah. Later. First one is source. First one is source of light. Source of what we are discussing now? Terms related to light. Terms related to what? Light. Terms related to what? Light. First one is source of light. What is mean by source of light? So it is source of light. Examples you can tell. We cannot define anything for source of light. Just we can say examples. What is the example for source of light? So best natural source is what? Sun. Natural source of the light is what? Sun. And next bulb. Bulb is a artificial source of light. Even torch light, bulb. Is there any other natural source of lights? Is a moon is a source of light?
Yes, sir.
Moon is a source of light?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, here actually based on the depends upon the source. We can define two types of sources. One is luminous bodies and non-luminous bodies. Better write on. One is luminous bodies. Second one is what? Non-luminous bodies. What is mean by luminous body? What is mean by luminous body? Luminous bodies are the source of lights which can produce, which can give the light easily, which can give the light easily. Okay, luminous bodies are the source of light. It can give the light without any depends. Understand? So example, sun is a luminous body. Examples you can write. Sun is a luminous body, and even stars also what? Stars also luminous body. Sun is also a star, and you know Minuguru Purugu, you know in Telugu we call Minuguru Purugu, that is also source of light, that is a luminous body, because naturally it is giving. It will not reflect the light, it is just giving the light, producing the light by mechanism, so that those are called luminous body. Here moon is not luminous body, it is a non-luminous body. What is mean by non-luminous body here? Non-luminous bodies are the object, just they reflect the light rays which is falling on the light, which is falling on the object, so that there appears like a source of light. Those source of light called as non-luminous bodies. Example is what? Moon. moon is not producing the light, just it is reflecting the light which is coming from the sun. Understand? So moon is a best example for what?
Non-luminous
body. You know, every human body, every wall, every object we can take as a non-luminous body, because they are not producing the light, they are only reflecting the light. Understand? So non-luminous body or luminous body, both we can consider as a source of light. Understand? Yeah. For today, I will stop the session. Tomorrow, I mean next class, will continue the remaining terms related to the light. Understand? I'll stop the session. Bye.